In machine learning, the concepts of weights and bias are the core of how models make predictions. Let's start with weights. Every input feature in your dataset, like a person's age, income, or number of study hours, is multiplied by a corresponding weight. The weight controls how important that feature is for the prediction. If the weight is high, the input has a strong influence. If it's low or zero, the model ignores it. If the weight is negative, the feature works in the opposite direction. Now, what about bias? The bias is a number that the model adds to the result of the weighted inputs. It allows the model to shift the prediction up or down, even when all input features are zero. Without bias, the model will be forced to always go through the origin, which limits its flexibility. Here's a simple example. Let's say we want to predict a student's test score based on how many hours they studied. Our model could look like this. Score equals to weight times hours plus bias. If the weight is 5 and the bias is 40, then studying 4 hours gives score equals to 5 times 4 plus 40 equals to 60. The model is saying each hour adds 5 points and everyone starts from a base score of 40. During training, the model doesn't know the best weight or bias. It starts with random values, makes predictions, checks how far it is from the correct answers, and then updates the weights and bias using an optimization algorithm like gradient descent. This process repeats, the model learns by adjusting weights and bias, gradually improving the accuracy of its predictions. To summarize, weights determine the importance of each input, and the bias allows the model to feed data that doesn't naturally go through zero. Together, they form the foundation of almost every model, from linear regression to deep neural networks. That's it.